Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this week's Spotlight Assembly beamed into your classrooms. I am Sophia, and my co-host is Jason. We are so excited and happy to be back in school.
Before we start, we would like to remind you about personal goals during our time in assemblies. Please make sure you are listening carefully throughout our assembly. This shows that you are being respectful penguins. We are going to start off with spotlight on music and have a very Christmassy treat in store from family.
Happy holidays.
Wow, thank you. That was great. I'm really feeling in the Christmas spirit now. Keep practicing your music, everyone at home, and that could be you playing for us all. Remember, learning to play an instrument is a skill, and the more you practice, the better you will get.
This week, our learners who are part of the intensive English program have been showcasing their progress with learning English in the special travel video. We also have some more creative challenges to share that were completed at home.
Welcome aboard Flight 2021 as we prepare to depart for destinations around the world.
Upon your arrival, you will see many new things in each country you visit.
You will get an inside look at different cultures and customs and learn unique traditions that you may have never seen before.
Please take a moment now to make sure your seat belts are securely fastened as we will be here to take off shortly.
We wish you a safe trip filled with learning and a very happy holiday.
Happy Diwali! My name is Marco and I'm going to tell you how people celebrate Diwali in Malaysia. It is celebrated sometimes during October or November. People eat mutton curry, muruku, laddu, and other food. People light up their house with tears, decorate rangoli, and worship for goddess Lakshmi. This festival is celebrated with sparkles, firecrackers, and fireworks are held in many places. People visit the local temple for prayers and share meals with family and friends. Children get small gifts and sweets. Diwali is also a festival of sound and sights with fireworks and rangoli designs. These are some of the photos of the traditional Indian food and dishes. Happy Diwali!
Merry Christmas! We are going to land in England. Christmas is a truly magical season, bringing families and friends together to share the much-loved customs and traditions. Most people are on holiday in the UK
and stay at home with their family on Christmas Day. The traditional Christmas dinner is in England includes roasted turkey or goose, Brussels sprouts, roast potatoes, pig in blankets and pudding. During the weekends before Christmas Day, people send cards, watch nativity plays and go to carol service. They put up Christmas decorations in their homes and churches. Pantomimes are great family entertainments. People go carol singing. People go from house to house singing carols and collect money for charity. People still feel uneasy about leaving the Christmas decorations up after 12 night because they believe that leaving the decorations up would cause a disaster. These are some of the photos of traditional English food and activities. Merry Christmas from Harvey. Bye.
Abarigani. My name's Crystal, and I'm going to tell you how people celebrate Kwanzaa. Kwanzaa is a cultural holiday that celebrates the African community. Family and values holidays foods are beans, rice, stew, chicken, and sweet desserts. People decorate their home in the color of red, green, and black. People may wear traditional African clothing. An important tradition in Kwanzaa has to do with a candle holder called the kinara. It holds 7 candles, including 3 red ones, 3 green ones, and 3 single black candles. Every candle represents a different value of African culture. These are some of the photos how people celebrate Kwanzaa. Habari gani? From Crystal.
Feliz Navidad. My name is Anderson, and I'm going to tell you how people celebrate Christmas in Mexico. They prepare 3 king cake and sweets. People in Mexico ride donkeys and party a lot. They decorate their house with evergreens, moss and paper lanterns. Children are at the house for friends and neighbors and sing the song at each home. In Mexico, the children expected Santa Claus to come on December 24th and they get presents. There are some of the photos of traditional Mexico food. Feliz Navidad from Anderson.
Welcome to India. My name is Ramisa, and I am going to tell you how people celebrate Sun Country in India. People start celebration on January 14th. They prepare Dahi Chuda, red pumpkin curry, and a sweet made from jaggery, sesame seeds, and rice, and many sweets. They also eat many nuts and fruits. As family traditions, people throw out old things and burn them. They wear new clothes. They decorate the cattle. They pray to soil and rain. Friends and families gather and throw sweets, sugarcane, and rice on the bonfires. After that, they bathe in the river to clean up their sins. Later, people join together to fly kites. These are some pictures of people flying kites and traditional foods.
Buon Natale. We are landing in Italy. My name is Luigi, and I am going to tell you how people celebrate Christmas in Italy. Christmas in Italy is celebrated over several weeks, as Italians celebrated from early December. In Italy, people usually eat 7 dishes for Christmas. Eggs include fish, Christmas cake called panettone, and spaghetti. Children hang up their stocking. People put up Christmas tree and decorate their house. Children go singing and playing songs. On Christmas Eve, often no food is eaten during the day as things as this is a fast day. Festive celebration, dawn after midnight, Babbo Natalie, Father Christmas, brings presents to children Christmas Eve. The children have been good throughout the last year. They will get some fruits, nuts, and sweets from Saint Nicholas. The naughty ones get usually also a sweet, but one looking like a coal. Are some of the photos of the traditional Italian food. We're not live from eating.
Chain quite little. My name is Stephen. I'm going to tell you how people celebrate the Chinese New Year in China. Chinese New Year. The date of Chinese New Year actually changes each year. It depends on the moon. People clean their homes really well to make them ready for the celebrations. People enjoy eating a lot of delicious food, including noodle soup, which traditionally bring luck for the year ahead. People enjoy fireworks, wear special clothes, and hang red lanterns on one occasion. Adults might give red envelopes to children with money inside. These are seven Chinese New Year foods to bring good luck. 新年快乐! From Stephen. The world is full of different beautiful characters that celebrate different holidays. Most of them involve families, food, and fun. Thank you for flying, Holiday Airlines. Bye!
From the captain and your flight crew here at Holiday Airways, we hope you enjoy your flight. Bye!
Okay, maybe let's add DNA to this beauty here. Dilophosaur!
Yep, that's me. You're probably wondering how I ended up in this situation.
Because of them. In the background, those two kids you see. Let's add some raptor DNA to make him climb. Copter, drop the raptor's foot. And the other one. That hurt badly. Initiate launch in 3, 2, 1. Ah! Come on, save me! My brother! Thank you so much for watching. Bye!
During the continuation of learning program, the learners in year 5 have been getting creative. Every week, our teachers give us 2, 3, or 4 challenges using different skills and themes. We would like to share some of them today.
So what I like is that the way I was creative and imaginative, so it looked like the food is about me. I feel really happy and proud that my photo was put onto the Google Classroom header.
Daniel from 5D. I like creative drawing because there is drawing and sides to make to draw, make your friends happy, and like sometimes even singing, and yeah. My favorite thing is drawing because and singing sometimes.
My favorite creative challenge was the shadow art challenge, as it was quite fun to make random and just real shadows.
Creative challenges, and I enjoy them very much because they are very creative. They give the side of your uniqueness and creativeness a chance to grow. They improve some things about you, like if there's a writing challenge and you're not good in writing, they improve your writing a lot too.
Creative challenges because we can improve our creativity and we can have loads of fun.
Liked about the creative challenges is that most of the challenges is device free. It is not good to keep staring at the screen. Creative challenges can keep us busy or moving around instead of being glued to our seats.
Fantastic learning, everyone! Now let's celebrate the birthdays of our learners who will have birthdays from the 5th to the 11th of December. Happy birthday to Zoe in year 1, Arab in year 2, Haikal in year 3, Alex and Bardi in year 4, Yuhania, Ilyas and Yuki in year 5, and Mehran and Ramisa in year 6.
Before we go to Miss Claire, from a final message, let's go to Ethan, who will be playing Happy Birthday. Please sing along at home.
Thank you so much to our wonderful presenters, Sophia and Jason. And thank you very much for sharing the wonderful learning that's been going on in school this week. So we have got a very special end of term Christmas celebration assembly for you next Wednesday. Something to look forward to, and we've got some really fun learning activities planned for next week also. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. Thank you so much to all of those people who have brought in some toys and clothes for the charity to help those children who really need those things at the moment. I've extended it slightly longer now. I will hang on till Wednesday, because since the school's been opened again, I've realised families have found it a bit easier to bring the things into school. So if you want to have a clear out this weekend of any unwanted clothes or toys, please do drop them into school. You can bring them into me or leave them at the guardhouse marked for charity, and I will make sure they all go to some really good homes. Okay, stay safe, have a lovely weekend. See you on Monday.